they preached the gospel of the kingdom accompanied by signs and wonders and following. Then the Lord sent 70 people 2 by 2. They preached the gospel of the kingdom followed by signs and wonders and following. The book of Acts, you read all the apostles preaching the gospel of the kingdom accompanied by signs and wonders following, and the church grew on the leaps and the bounds. The then known whole world became a Christian world within a short period of time, 60 years. From the time the Lord Jesus died, in a 60-year period or 50-year period, the then known whole world became a Christian world. Now, after 2000 years, with all the modern gadgets that we have today, with all the modern technology that we have today, we have hardly scratched beyond half a billion, half the world. What's wrong? Because we have programs. You know, I was meditating today on a devotional. I read a devotional. It talks about a, now, please listen with all your heart and don't get me wrong. I'm just making a point across. A youth group from a church went on a mission trip, and the focus or the agenda was to show the love of Christ to the third world people. So what did they do? They went and built houses, they repaired this, they repaired that, they showed the love of Christ. So when I read that, I pondered, because when I heard Brother Neville's message last night, I went back and I skimmed through the scriptures. Look at every time the Lord Jesus preached the gospel, every time the disciples preached the gospel, it was the gospel of the kingdom accompanied by signs and wonders following. That is the pattern. When the Lord Jesus sent out the disciples, he gave them 2 commands. 1, preach the gospel of the kingdom. 2, heal the sick. This is a command. That does not mean we cannot do good. That should be secondary, not the primary focus. So because the secondary now becomes the primary focus, we are no more winning the loss. We are no more. Remember the statement that the Lord told Brother Neville, keep the main thing, the main thing. Amen. We have lost the main thing. We have lost the main focus of our existence. What's the purpose of the church? Not to be a club. Ephesians chapter 4 verses 11 to 13 says, God gave an apostle, the prophet, the evangelist, the pastor and teacher to equip the church so that they will all become ministers of God, to do the work of an evangelist, not to warm the pews, not to find your life partner in the church, not to create problem in the church, divide the church, and then you start another church. See, the real purpose of a church is to equip the church so that you become a proof producer, a power demonstrator. That's the purpose. And what are we doing from the day that you get saved till now? How many souls have you brought into the kingdom of God? Maybe you may say to me, I'm hardly surviving myself. Every day I'm dying, I'm resurrecting myself. I am backsliding and then I'm getting revived. I'm backsliding and I'm getting revived. All my life, I only have enough time to save myself. How can I go and evangelize others when I am dying and resurrecting, dying and resurrecting? This cannot go on forever. One day you'll find that you're not able to resurrect anymore. You are dead forever.